come back home or to the airport of the past. It's still nice. Come on, this used to be the symbol of luxury and the big wide world and of a modern airport 20 years ago when they started to construct Dubai as a hub. And the Golden Palm was promising miracles of cars which you could win easily with just a little money to invest. Still nice. Look at this. So Qatar is using this little lounge here together with some other airlines like Swiss, Korean, Kuwait. And it's a small lounge, but it's quite okay, I thought. Quite a big selection of spirits, wines. I don't see champagne though. And also a very decent selection of breakfast items. Not too bad. Actually, the choice is quite good, I must say. Wouldn't have expected it in this little lounge here. Terminal 1 is opposite. Really quite good. So there is champagne in the lounge, right? What champagne is it? Can you show me? It's Heidsieck. Okay, thank you. So Homer is going healthy. I'm not drinking champagne, I'm drinking Laban, the famous yogurt drink which they like in the Middle East, and I like it too. Cheers!
المسافرين الدرجة السياحية بلغ بإبراز حافظات التذاكر الملونة للمضيفين الأرضيين وذلك وقع روتانا أوركس هنا بالدوحة. خلاص المسافرين ترانزيت على الدرجة الأولى والعمال سوف
Kindly proceed to the new arrival terminal for immigration and customs clearance. Our transit customers flying first or business class to onward destination with Qatar Airways. Your ground transfer will take you to our exclusive premium terminal where you can relax, unwind and enjoy your five-star facilities. Please present your premium invitation card to the ground staff as you zoom back.
ستتوقف الحافلة التي تستقلونها عند متنعي المنفصلين. يرجى الانتباه للآن.
So this is the premium transfer terminal, and as you can see, all gates are right here, just next to each other, because you are then taken with the bus to your aircraft. And this is the way up to the lounges. So let's go to the business class lounge, which I think is much bigger than the first class lounge, at least compared to what I have seen. So here is a dining area, it seems. All kinds of food. And then the lounge is pretty big. So this is already quite big, and then there is another part up here. There seems to be another bar here, is it? Oriental Brasserie, 6 p.m. to 1 a.m. So this is only in the evening, it seems. Okay. So there's nothing here yet. I wonder whether they serve beer here, probably. So let's leave the brasserie. So that's where we came in, and the dining area is. And now let's go to this other big part of the lounge. That's a big seating area, and very nice. They have a sleeping. There's also a bar area. Funny, all kinds of marmalade. It really looks like the breakfast area here. Okay. All right. And then let's move down again. Okay, so here we have this little bar, and I see a whole selection of wines. Can you tell me what wines we have?
We have Tangari La Rote.
Can you show it to
Australia.
Me? Yeah.
This is the Australian wine, Shiraz.
It's Shiraz. Okay.
And we have Pomerol, Bordeaux from France.
That's Bordeaux from France, 2007. Yes.
Saint-Emilion also, the Bordeaux.
That's another Bordeaux.
Yeah, another Bordeaux.
2006. Oh, you know your Bordeaux, huh? So what about white wines?
White wines, we have Chardonnay from France, 2007.
Okay.
And we have Sauvignon Blanc, Villa Maria from this New Zealand, 2011.
Sounds, yeah, sounds New Zealand. Wonderful. What about champagne?
Champagne, we have Cru. This is our champagne.
Yes. Okay. Thank you very much, sir.
And also the we have non-alcoholic champagne.
What is it?
Non-alcoholic champagne.
Oh, non-alcoholic champagne.
Someone will like to bring non-alcoholic drinks?
Yes, we also have non-alcoholic beer in Germany. But I don't like it. So this is the lunch area. With the sweets. And let me choose a table. I think I'll take this one. So, some starters, lamb filet. What else do we have? Chicken tikka. Sumac roast chicken in mini pita pockets. Cheese fatayar. Lamb kebab. All kinds of chutneys. Some bread. Potato salad. Chicken tikka salad. It all looks very nice, I must say. Okay, so this is the menu presented. Thank you very much, sir. Let me see what they have. So that's from the brasserie, which is, I don't know, that's where I've been to. Now this looks really good. My goodness, this is amazing. So this is the freshly prepared veal steak. Looks fantastic. So, my white wine is coming. Hello, how are you? This is really a first-class service. Tia Maria from New Zealand. Thank you very much. Thank you. Excellent. Thank you very much. This was really an express meal.
Salmon?
Fantastic.
Salmon.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, sir. Look at this. I mean, I'm totally impressed to have this in a business class lounge, to have an a la carte menu. Salmon is delicious, freshly prepared, not overcooked, juicy. Really, I mean, this sets new standard in business class lounge food, I must say. this little starter normally you just only get in first class. Absolutely amazing. So I picked this Austrian Grüner Berliner, which is very rare in the air. They say this grape will be world famous in a couple of years. It has been world famous with me for 30 years because I lived in Austria some time ago. And it has a really nice taste of all kinds of fruit, apple, pear, citrus, and also a lot of minerals and pepper. What is it?
A soup, sir.
Which soup is it?
The honey rose parsley.
Honey? Okay. Thank you so much. So this is the Brunello? Yes. Please.
You want to taste it
first. Rectangles don't rotate, they just move in a rectangular way. Aren't the rectangles after all? Visiting the economy cabin. So what do we have here? Can you show me? Can you explain me?
About
which wines do we have?
We have a white and red wines.
Okay.
we have an Italian Pinot Grigio.
First, you have champagne.
Champagne, yes.
I mean, it's amazing. I don't know any airline except Air France which serves champagne in economy. But Air France, I think, gives you only one glass.
Unlimited.
It's unlimited. Amazing.
It's going to be nicely chilled. That's
fantastic.
Champagne. Unlimited.
Yes.
And we have a
then you have
the new options, which
okay.
is Italian Pinot Grigio.
Yes.
2010, 2011, and the
yes.
French Chardonnay 2011.
Yes.
And that's the French Syrah 2011.
It's the Syrah is from
France.
Yes, but from
Spanish.
Within France, do we know what it is exactly? We don't know.
Sure.
Is it Paydoc?
Yeah, Paydoc.
Okay.
And Rioja, the Spanish Rioja, Madrada from the 2010. And we have a few Drumbly, still have their whiskey, gin, vodka.
Amazing. Lena.
Sorry, again, sir.
Grüne Welt Lena.
Grüne Welt Lena.
Oh, this was perfect almost. Say it again.
Grüne Welt Lena.
Perfect. You're half an Austrian. So what is it this time?
This one is the Austrian.
Grüne Welt Lena. Yes.